Hello, my crafty friends. Today is the second of the month, and that means it's time for another sheetload of cards. The sheetload of cards is the brainchild of Alicia at Call Me Crafty Al. This is a sketch, supply list, and cutting guide that is free for subscribers to her YouTube channel. All the information is in the description box below. I am on the YouTube collaboration team, but there is also an Instagram collaboration team as well as a blog collaboration team. All of those links are also in the description box below. Let me show you the cards that I made with the September sheet load. The yield this month is 8 cards. It uses 2 12 by 12 pattern papers, and I made all 8 of my cards into birthday cards. The pattern paper that I used is a 12 by 12 pattern paper pad by Die Cuts with a View. It's called Cute Cute Cacti. I've had this pad for several years. So I picked out some of the prints from the pad for my cards today. The cute cactus images come from Cool Cactus by Your Next Stamp. This is a set that was in their last release, and I loved it, and I haven't had nearly enough playtime with it. So I knew that's what I wanted to use for my card today. So I used this one on the front, and inside I stamped a second one in kind of a lighter colored ink. There are coordinating dies also available. I didn't use them for my card today. I stamped it right on the banner. Now I did deviate a little bit. Once I laid out my card, I knew I wanted to put, because I had an image here, I wanted to put a sentiment. I thought about putting happy and birthday on paper strips to mimic the embellishment she has here underneath the banner layers, but nothing I did looked right. So finally I decided to just go ahead and add the birthday wishes. That is another Your Next Stamp set. This is from Washi Tape Sentiments, and there are also coordinating dies available. This is a stamp set that I use so much. It stays on my stamping table because there's a great variety of sentiments in it for many different occasions. So there's the birthday wishes there that I used on my card. I also used the coordinating die, the washi tape die, and I inked the edges with domed blending sponges. I also used the Subtles embossing folder on this piece. That was my New Year's resolution for 2021, was to use my embossing folders more. So I did pull it out for this, and I really like the subtle texture it gives. I hope it shows up in video. It reminds me very much of the textured basil cardstock. Because I like embellishments in groups of threes, I added a green Nouveau drop and let that dry. My birthday cards will all be donated to my mom's old nursing home. I donate 25 birthday cards a month, and it's always a good opportunity when I have a sheet load to add to that stash. This was actually a different layout for me. I usually leave a white border. I tend not to cover my card fronts with patterned paper, but I quite liked it, and I'm glad that I didn't change that up on the sheet load. It made it very easy to make them following the cutting guide. Because this is an older pattern paper pad, I was trying to use up some of the partial sheets. I do have 2 with a different print on them because I didn't have enough of this print to finish all 8 of the cards. So I just used another partial sheet for that one. And actually, these are not my favorite prints in the package, so I used up a whole nother sheet by adding a panel to the inside. So they're a little bit heavy, but I like the look of it. It brightened up the inside. The stamp inside comes from Birthday Blowout by Poppy Stamps. This is another stamp set that I've had for several years, and I get so much use out of it. Works really well for the nursing home cards. I really like the size of the sentiments. And then, as I said, I added another little cute cacti there, and I'm happy with my cards. Every month when I donate the cards, I try to have some that are more masculine, some that are feminine with florals, and then some generic. So I think these ones would work good for my masculine cards. So those are my cards for today. Make sure you check that description box below. I have my blog link there where all the available supplies are linked, and also how you can download your own sheet load of cards, as well as all of the links for the rest of the collaboration team. If you enjoyed my video today, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to see more. And that's it for me today.